you are about to see an opera for beggars. Since this opera was conceived with a splendor only a beggar could imagine, and since it had to be so cheap, even a beggar could afford it, it is called the Three Penny Opera. The Market, Soho, Monday night. Oh, the shark has pretty teeth, dear, and he shows them pearly white. Just a jackknife has Maggie, dear, and he keeps it out of sight.
When the shark bites with his teeth, dear, scarlet billows start to spread. Fancy gloves, though, where's my heat here? So there's not a trace of red.
On the sidewalk, Sunday morning, lies a body oozing life. Someone's sneaking round the corner. Is that someone? Mack the knife.
From a tugboat by the river, a cement bag's dropping down. The cement's just for the weight, dear. Betcha Mackie's back in town.
Sloppy Sadie was discovered with a knife wound in her thigh, and MacHeath strolls down on Dock Street, looking dreamy at the sky.
There was rape down by the harbor. Little Susie caused a stir, claiming that she'd been assaulted. Wonder what got into her. Suki Tawtree, Jenny Diver, Holly Fisher, Lucy Brown, all the life force on the right, dear. Now that Mackie's back in town.
Oh, the shark has pretty teeth, dear, as he shows them pearly white. Just a jackknife has a key, dear, as he keeps it out of sight.
Just a jackknife has Maggie, dear, and he keeps it.
Look, there goes Mack the Knife.
J.J. Ketchum has opened a shop in which the poorest of the poor may achieve an appearance designed to melt the hardest of hearts. Ketchum's Beggar's Outfit Shop, Tuesday morning.
Wake up, you damned godless, wake up. Come open your sinful blue eyes. With greed runneth over your cup. So start the day's blessings and lies. Sell him out your own brother you love, and chuck your poor mother above. The good Lord up above you is watching.
My firm, the Beggar's Big Brother, specializes in this commodity. Human pity is my business, and business is terrible. Something new must be found. There are a few things, a very few, that do touch the human heart, but they dwindle. The more you use them, the less they move. Because people have a fearful capacity to turn their feelings on and off. They can become callous at will. Now, what good are the finest, most spiritual slogans, all painted by hand in the most artistic manner, if they wear out their welcome so soon? The Good Book has some 4 or 5 real money makers. This one, for example. One of our best numbers. That was a 3-weeker. So what do? You go back to the Bible, but even the Bible is not inexhaustible. How long can it go on? Come in.
Peachum and Company?
I'm Peachum.
So it's your firm, the Beggar's Big Brother. I was recommended to you.
Your name?
If you please, sir. All my life, I've been cursed with misfortune. My mother was a drunkard, and my father a gambler. Looking out for myself at an early age, never knowing the loving hand of a mother, I have sunk deeper and deeper into the bog of the big city. Fatherly advice and an intimate home life, I never knew them. So now you see me.
I see you.
Bereft of any wherewithal whatsoever, the sad victim of my own miserable instincts.
Like a forlorn wreck on the open seas, and I can't remember the rest. Tell me, you forlorn wreck, where do you blab this ring around a rosy?
I don't follow you, Mr. Peachum.
You actually delivered this speech in public.
Well, you see, Mr. Peachum, yesterday there was this painful little happening over on Highland Street. I was just standing there, quiet and miserable, holding on my hat with no thought of wrongdoing at all.
Highland Street. Got it. You know, the worms that Sam and Honey discovered yesterday. You had the impudence to beg in District 10. We let you off with a light going over. We decided you didn't know the good Lord's exact address, which is here. Get caught there again and you'll get the saw, understand?
But please, sir, what can I do? Those men beat me pretty bad. I'm black and blue. They produced your business card.
Only professionals get licenses. The City of London is divided into 14 districts. A person wishing to practice the trade of begging in any one of them must have a license from Jonathan Jeremiah Peachum and Company. Why, all London could go about begging the sad victims of their miserable instincts.
But please, Mr. Peachum, what can I do? I've only got a few paltry shillings left, with only 2 shillings in my pocket.
20 shillings. £1.
Mr. Peachum! ten shillings?
Plus 60% of your weekly intake, including the costume, 70%.
If you please, sir, what will the costume be?
The company decides that. Your name?
Charles Filch.
Charles Filch. Mrs. Peter!
What?
This is Filch, number 314 Baker Street District. I suppose you want to begin now, before the Queen's coronation, a few days in a lifetime when real money can be earned. Well, let's see, outfit 1 or 2.
Oh, it's all that.
You see before you the basic types of human misery calculated to touch the heart. One look at these people will bring a man to that unnatural condition where he's actually willing to part with money. Let's see, a cheerful cripple, a nervous twitcher. That one's my favorite. Victim of the rise of industrialism, the heartbreaking cyclist, postgraduate in the art of begging. Pity! He feels pity. I'll never make a professional beggar, not if you live to be 1,000, you're only fit to be begged from. Well, maybe outfit number 1. And it's your early morning drinking again, Celia? Yeah, get out of those and into these. Only keep your uniform in proper condition.
my things.
Those? Property of the company. And who's asking the questions? Just get out of those clothes.
But sir, they're just the least bit filthy. Excuse it.
Well, hurry it up, Ducky. We can't hold your pants for you until Christmas. And off with the shoes, too.
My shoes?
Uh-huh.
I'm not gonna take off my shoes. They were my poor mother's gift to her only son. I'll never part with my shoes. Never. Even though I've sunk pretty low.
Drop it, Doss. We know your feet ain't roses.
But where am I supposed to wash them in the middle of winter?
I don't care!
Where's your daughter?
Polly? Upstairs. Why?
Was that man here again?
What man? Don't be so suspicious, Jonathan. There isn't a finer gentleman alive than the captain. And if my eyes don't deceive me, I think he might have a sweet tooth for our Polly. And I think Polly might find him most attractive.
Celia, you toss your daughter about as though I were a millionaire. Polly with a husband, he'd have his claws into us. Oh. You suppose your daughter can hold her tongue in bed any better than you can?
You have a fine opinion of our daughter.
The worst, only the very worst. She's nothing but a heap of carnal notions.
She certainly never got them from you.
Polly was a bridegroom. I'm expecting my daughter to be the solace of my old age. That's even in the good book somewhere. Marriage is a doomed scam. I'll tear the marriage out of her.
Ugh, Jonathan, you are just ill-bred.
Ill-bred? What's his name, this fine gentleman?
I don't know. We simply referred to him as the captain.
And you didn't think to ask his name. Perfect.
Well, it would have been rude to produce a birth certificate, especially after he was kind enough to take us to the Octopus Arms for a little dance.
Where?
To the Octopus Arms for a little dance.
Captain, Octopus Arms.
Ugh, don't worry, my lord never even touched me. Or our daughter, for that matter, except for with his fancy kid gloves on.
Fancy kid gloves.
Fancy yellow kid gloves.
Fancy yellow kid gloves. In a cane with an ivory head, with spats on his shoes, in a charming manner. Yes, a scar.
On his neck, how'd you know all that?
Mr. Peachum, can I get some advice? I've always been one for a plan of action, and I wouldn't want to make any serious mistakes.
Now he wants a plan of action.
Simple, he can act himself, the idiot.
That he can.
Come back after 6 and you'll get all you need. Now brush off.
Thank you, Mr. Peachum, thank you so much.
And now I'll tell you who your fine gentleman is with the kid gloves. It's MacHeath, Mac the Knife.
What?
Polly!
Oh, Jesus, come and be our host. Where's Polly?
Polly hasn't slept in her bed.
What? Well, she... No, I'm sure she just went out for a bite with friends. Jonathan, I'm sure of it.
I hope to God it's just a bite. And I hope it's with friends.
Oh.
Instead of staying home in bed and not behaving,
they want love, they want love, chasing down the alley with a sentimental craving. They caught that moon over Dock Street. They have the "You Feel My Heart Beating" blues. They have that "Anywhere You Go, I Will Go With You." For that old-fashioned love tickle still makes news. Instead of
Street. What happened to them? You feel my heart beating blues. Where is that? Anywhere you go,
I will go with you.
Call that old-fashioned glove tingle. Last year's news.
In the heart of Soho, the band at Mac tonight celebrates its marriage to Polly Peacher, daughter of the banker's big brother. An empty stable. Tuesday evening.
Is anybody here?
Empty. We can hold the wedding here nice and peaceful. About to take place my marriage to Miss Polly Peachum, who out of love for me has followed me and sworn to be mine for the rest of her life.
No, but you can't be thinking of having our wedding here. Yeah. It's a common stable. How can you invite the minister to a stable? And it's not even ours. You know, Mackie, we shouldn't be starting our new life with the house breaking. This is supposed to be the most beautiful day of all.
My dearest, dearest one, everything shall be as you would have it. Your tiny foot shall not touch one bare stone. I do believe I hear the furnishings arriving.
Decorations, this way!
This way, come on, guys, follow me.
Chuck! Polly, I believe I see a moon over Dock Street.
Come on. Where?
Wish you the best of luck. 14 Ginger Street. Had to smoke out a family on the second floor. Angels.
Wish you the best of luck. Albemarle Street, when copper got a little bit in our way.
Wish you the best of luck. We were perfect gentlemen, but three characters on Berkeley Square will be seen no more.
Bunglers and apes.
One old cavalier went flat on his face and didn't get up. It may be serious. Luck again!
My orders were avoid violence. I get sick when I think of it. You'll never make professionals. Gorillas, perhaps, but never professionals.
Wish you the best of luck.
Those poor people! Because of some furniture?
And what furniture? You are quite right, Beatrice.
No, Becky, I'm so unhappy. Well, I hope at least the minister will come.
Of course he'll come. We wrote out the directions for him. Straight from St. James's Club.
Here you are.
My wife is upset. How often is it that I get married?
Shut up!
How often is it, I ask you, that I leave anything to you? You have made my wife unhappy at the very outset.
Dearest Polly!
Dearest Polly, I'll cram that dearest Polly down your craw. Who's calling her dearest Polly here? Perhaps you slept with her too.
Mackie. I swear to you!
Dearest madam, if there are any few things you would...
As the bride, what do you think?
Well, I guess it could be a lot worse.
A pincushion, a painting, and the wedding guests sit on the ground.
Oh, wouldn't that be something?
Bill Orton and Mary Sawyer last Friday, man and wife became to the happy couple. Yay!
Hooray!
one more chair.
Gentlemen, might I request some sartorial effort?
Is that a kind of wine?
The flowers.
Oh, the flowers.
And Polly, might I request that you preside over the refreshments?
Was that the way, Summer? Is it all stolen goods, Maggie?
Yes.
You know, I'm wondering what you would do if there was a knock on the door and the police commissioner just walked in.
Then you would see what your husband is made of.
Not today, not likely. All the police are out at the palace guarding it for the coronation.
Oh, that's right, that's right.
Captain, with your permission.
Yes. Polly, if you please.
Oh, no, Mr. Matt, my first champagne.
With your permission, Captain. On this, the most beautiful day of your lives, in the springtime flood of your career, as it were, so to speak, its crossroads, we wish to offer you our most heartfelt and fervent wishes for a long and happy, and so on and so forth. You know, this kind of talk makes me throw up. Happy nights, old pal.
Thank you, Matthew. That was very nice.
And I mean it from the heart. Keep it up high, you old roué. What I mean to say is, never let a thing go down that ought to stand up. Knock it off.
Save your dirty jokes for your girl, Kitty. She's the right bitch for them.
Maggie, well, don't be common.
I do not like your calling Kitty a bitch.
Oh, you don't, eh?
And what's more, I never tell dirty jokes when Kitty's around. I respect her too much. A thing you would never understand, being built the way you are. You ought to mention dirty jokes. Lucy told me the one you told her. Me? I'm elegant compared to that.
Who's Lucy?
Wait a minute. This is a wedding.
A fine wedding. What, Polly? Putting up with these sewer rats
on
your wedding day.
Mackie, I think it's a sweet wedding.
Yeah, he didn't mean nothing by it, Mackie. Matt, your kitty's as good as anybody else. Come on with your wedding gift now. Give it to
me. Oh, right. This is your present.
You want a present?
Where?
Here it is.
It's my present. Oh, it's beautiful. Look, Mackie. Oh, what a lovely nightgown.
I suppose that's a dirty joke too, huh, Captain? All right. I didn't mean to lose my temper on this solemn day.
It's beautiful. I'm so happy. I have no words. Your kindness overwhelms me.
All right, let's clear some of this junk and let's eat.
Of course, I forgot to bring you anything.
Oh, Mr. Jake. Mr. Crookfinger Jake. No, do please forget it.
Well, everybody brings presents, but I just stand around. It's always like that. I'm always putting my foot in it. A couple of days ago, I saw Jenny. Mackie's Jenny, you know.
Oh, sister, you old bird. Elegant place, the Savoy Hotel.
Oh, the stuffed breads are from Fortnum and Mason's. We also had a jar of caviar, but on the way over, Matt ate it all up. He said he was so pooped.
Nice people do not say pooped.
Yeah, don't talk like that. This is formal.
Perhaps somebody could sing something. Something diverting.
Something diverting? Now there's a word.
Well, I just hadn't thought we'd start eating quite yet. All this in the mug and down the trough behavior. I should have preferred to start with something with a bit of charm.
That is usually what happens on such occasions.
Such as what?
Do I have to think of everything myself? I'm not asking for grand opera. But something other than stuffing your faces and telling dirty jokes might have been arranged.
Well, Mackie, the Pilchards are wonderful.
Oh, yes, indeed. I've always said that Mac is the type for a girl with higher feelings. That's what I was even telling Lucy yesterday.
Lucy? Who is Lucy?
Oh, now, don't you get any wrong ideas about Lucy.
Do you need something? Some salt?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, here you go.
Thank you.
Now, what were you saying, Mr. Jake?
Nothing. Nothing at all. Well, what I really meant to say actually was positively nothing at all. I'd better get out of here.
So I guess there will be no song. Nothing to brighten up the proceedings. No. It's just gonna be another one of those miserable, ordinary, goddamn lousy days like always.
Well, gentlemen, if no one else will sing, then I will do a little something myself. I will imitate a girl I once saw. She was barmaid and scrub woman at a pub on Dock Street, and they all laughed at her. But then one day, she spoke up to the customers. Now, one of you must say, you. When's your ship coming in, Jenny?
When's your ship coming in, Jenny?
Okay, another one of you must say, no. You. Are you still scrubbing floors, Jenny, the pirate sweetheart?
Are you still scrubbing floors, Jenny, the pirate sweetheart?
All right, and now I start. Oh, you realize that I've never been there personally? It's just a song. Gentlemen can watch while I'm scrubbing the floors, and I'm scrubbing the floors while you're going. And maybe once you tip me and it makes you feel swell, on a ratty waterfront in a ratty old hotel. Never as to who you're talking. You never as to who you're talking. Suddenly one night there's a scream in the night, and you wonder where the person lives up there. And you sing a kind of grinning while I'm scrubbing. And you sing what the hell she's got to grin. And the ship, the Black Freighter, with the skull on its masthead, will be coming in. You gentlemen can say, hey girl, finish the floors. Get upstairs, make the beds, earn your keep here. You toss me your tips and look out at the ships. But I'm counting your heads while I make up the beds. Cause nobody's gonna sleep here. Tonight, none of you will sleep here. And that night, there's a bang in the night, and you yell, who's that kicking up a rail? And you see her kind of staring at the window. And you say what she's got to stare at now. And the ship, the Black Freighter, turns around in the harbor, shooting guns from the bow. Gentlemen can wipe off that laugh from your face. Every building in town is a blood one. Your whole sticky place will be down to the ground. Only this cheap hotel standing up safe and sound. And you yell, why the hell spare that one? And you yell, why the hell spare that one? All the night through, with the noise and to do, you wonder who the person lives up there. And you see me stepping out into the morning, looking nice with a ribbon in my hair. And the ship, the Black Freighter, runs a flag up its masthead, and a cheer rings the air. Swarming with men, coming off of that blue sleeve freighter. They're running in the shadows where no one can see. And they're chaining up people and bringing them to me. Asking me, kill them now or later. Asking me, kill them now or later. Noon on the clock, and so still on the dock. You can hear a foghorn miles away. In the quiet of death, I'll say, right now. And they pile up their bodies, and I will say, that'll warn ya.
There's no point. Besides, I don't like you parading yourself. So from now on, no more of that. I guess I'll go outside and keep guard. I'll keep watch while you stuff yourself to my expense.
What do you mean, your expense?
It's all right, Jerry. I'll go out.
Who come here anyway?
Wouldn't it be funny if all us wedding guests got pinched today?
After it! It's a copper! Brown! Tiger Brown! It's Reverend Kimball, you fool!
Oh, evening, Reverend.
Well, indeed. Here, I find you a sordid little hovel it is. But one's own.
How do you do, Reverend? Oh, God, it makes me so happy to see a minister on the most beautiful day of my
life. Reverend! The commissioner himself!
It's Brown!
Tiger Brown!
Himself, in person.
It's the gallows for us!
I've been expecting us. Tiger Brown, chief pillar of the Old Bailey, about to enter the humble and, I hope, temporary abode of Captain McKee. Ah, Jackie, my boy.
Hello, hello, Mac. Now listen, I've only a little time. I must be going very soon. Now look. Oh, this place, Mackie. I'm afraid we'll have to count it somebody else's stable. That makes one more unlawful entry, Mac.
It just seems so suitable. Let me present my bride, Polly, born Peachum.
I'm very happy to make the acquaintance of the bride of my old friend, Mackie.
Not at all, sir.
May I present the very Reverend Ernest Kimball, who will be officiating.
I mean, how do you do?
And Jackie, these are my boys. Some of them may be familiar.
Oh, please, just for today. I don't know anybody. Gentlemen, please be seated.
Take a seat, old lover boy, and dive into the liquor. Polly, gentlemen, you see here in your midst a man who the queen's matchless wisdom has placed high above his fellow man. Never before have I, humble safe cracker that I am, never before have I put my hand in the tiniest of operations without sharing the proceeds with him. My friend, Brown, and never before has the distinguished commissioner organized a raid without giving me some previous little hint. And so it goes. It's always give and take. Genuine Parisian silk.
And hoisted direct from Peter Robinson's. That's where I get all my linens.
Oh, Jackie, do you recall the days when we two were soldiers? You a soldier, me a soldier. We fought together in India, in the Sudan, in 100 battles.
Mackie,
remember?
Rating.
Don't give your right name, the army don't care.
But the life is so fascinating. Let's all go Barney, live off the army, see the world we never saw. We'll need a darker race, we'll fight them face to face. Cause if it's clear we're better, we'll kill them, it doesn't matter. We'll chop them up and make from them a beefsteak tartare. Jimmy did not drink tea. And George replied with a right to the chin.
But the arm is just a pink tea.
Let's all go Barbie. Live off the arm.
Jimmy is dead and George went crazy shooting. But blood is blood and red is bloody red.
And the army is still recruiting.
Anything amiss should happen at the coronation.
Oh, Jackie, one small point. My father-in-law is a rather disagreeable type. If you were to make a stink about our marriage, is there anything in Scotland Yard's records against me?
Mackie, Scotland Yard, there is absolutely nothing about you.
I knew it. You didn't have to tell me.
That's all been taken care of. And now, good night.
Oh, gentlemen, please rise.
The very best of luck to you, ma'am.
Goodbye, Steve.
Boy, I gotta admit, a big shiver ran right down me when Tiger Brown came in.
Aha! You see, ma'am, how high our official connections go.
Oh, yes. Our Mackie always has a few irons in the fire that we don't know about. But us two lads, we have our own iron in the fire.
Boys,
it's 9:30. Aha! Now for the big moment!
What's going on?
Captain, please, another little surprise.
License is your truth. No.
finds the lost of his daughter, a woman's love. Peachum's Beggar's Outfit Shop, Wednesday
Can I get my advice for the day?
You take care of that, I'll take care of this.
Listen to me, my friend. Between moving people and aggravating them, there is a big difference. What I need are artists! These days it takes artists if you want to move the hearts of men. If you gave a decent performance, you should get applause, but who has brains? You watch it. I may not decide to extend your engagement. And you've been eating again. Look at you, you're plump! I'm gonna have to make an example out of you.
No, Mr. Peacham, I don't eat. I just get fat. It's unnatural.
I'll go to Wapping and I'll talk to Jenny, his old duck. I could talk to any one of those women, but I'll talk to Jenny. And if he goes to see any of them in the next day or two, that'll be that. And he will. Now there's a man, the living tool of Satan. He charges forth while others are debating. Conniving cockney knave with all the trimming. I know one thing will trim him down. Women. On women he meets deep authority. At the good book mocks the priss and prim, does anything for pay if it will pay. And since he knows what ladies do to him, he thrusts them well out of his way. All through the day he swears he's self-denying, but dusk descends and once again he's lying. They're all the same in meeting love's confusion. Poor wretched souls get caught up in delusion. The one who swore he could escape their clinches. Who is it now entangles him? Wenches. He fain resists their lush authority. No, he still has that old dependency. He hugged the Ten Commandments, trod the tried and true, would godly be and golden rule obey. For lunch ate frugally a grape or two, survived on one pure thought a day. He screams, I've mastered it without half trying. Appears the moon and once again he's lying. Idiots. All of them.
Mama, you can save yourself the trouble from going all the way out to Wapping. Before, my Mackie would deign to consult with such females. He'd even go to jail.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and if he went to jail, the commissioner of police mm-hmm. would offer him a brandy, and over a cigar, they would discuss a certain shop in the street that wasn't quite what it seemed like either, because,
my dear Mama,
the police commissioner enjoyed himself hugely at my wedding.
Oh, he did.
Mm-hmm. He sipped brandy together and said, if you will have another, then I will have another. And when the other departed, the other's eyes filled up with tears and said, anywhere you go, I will go with you. So there is not a thing in the records against Mackie.
Maybe there wasn't before, there will be now. He seduced my daughter.
I don't know, Jonathan. We are dealing with Mackie. The slipperiest criminal in all of London. Suppose it doesn't work.
It will work. With me paying a visit to the Commissioner of Police and you doing your part in Wapping.
Leave it to me.
As for me, Papa, I shall be very pleased to greet Mr. Brown again.
Oh, the wickedness of the world is so great you have to keep running so your legs won't be stolen from under you.
All I'm asking is much. Once, instead of all the sadness, throw the man a little gladness. Is that asking very much? Is that asking such a much?
One ride is guaranteed to everybody. To call his short unhappy life his own. To take a bit of pleasure with the shoddy. And when he asks for bread to eat, not get a stone. This human right belongs to everybody. But sad to say, it never yet has happened that things should go the way they ought to go. We all deserve a little decent treatment. It seems that circumstance won't have it so.
I could gladly give to you anything your heart desired, or I swear it'd be inspired. It would give me pleasure to.
We crave to be more kindly than we are. Give freely to the poor because it's right. If all are kind, his kingdom can't be far. Who wouldn't want to bask beneath his light? We crave to be more kindly than we are. But sad to say, the chances happen never. You have to reach up high and man is low. We'd all deserve to live in peace forever. It seems that circumstance won't have it so.
Sad to say, he tells the truth. The world is mean and man uncouth.
Of course I'm telling you the truth. The world is mean and man uncouth. Who wouldn't want this heaven on earth now? But you know circumstance will it allow. No circumstance will not allow. Your brother, he was dear to you, but when the groceries are through, you both begin a running race, and running he steps on your face. Your wife, oh, she was dear to you, but when her love for you is through, you both begin a running race, and running she steps on your face. Your daughter, she was dear to you, but when there isn't food for two, another plant she starts to chase, and running she steps on your face.
It always happens that way, it always happens that way. The world is me, and man uncouth, and sad to say, he tells the truth.
Of course I'm telling you the truth, the world is me, and man uncouth, to be a glow instead of low. But you know circumstance won't have it so. To be a glow instead of low. Circumstance won't happen.